Hey everybody, my name is Dan, and welcome to my channel. Today I've got some NBA 2K18 4K gameplay recorded on the new Xbox One X. Got a game here of the Cavs versus the New York Knicks. So, hope you enjoy. Sit back and relax. You know, grab some popcorn, grab some peanuts, watch the game, and stay tuned for some more 4K gameplay. Got a whole stack of games ready to make videos about on the Xbox One X, as well as, of course, some games on PC, PS4 Pro, and some stuff on the Nintendo Switch as well. So stay tuned, and I'll see you next time.
David Aldridge, who was able to talk with head coach Jeff Hornacek.
Well, guys, when I asked him what impressed him the most about today's opponent, he immediately referred to the explosiveness on their offense. He said they have so many different ways to hurt you that it's impossible to take away everything. It's just about damage control. He acknowledged they've got a big job to do defensively. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. The new year getting ramped up, always a roller coaster ride, which is fun. Brent, have you ever been on a team that, say, started slowly, then really turned it on late, or the other way around?
Well, I've been on teams that started slowly and finished slower, Kevin, if that helps you out at all.
That's not good.
Yeah, no fun whatsoever. A little bit of both throughout 14 years of playing experience in the NBA, Kevin, and it's just interesting. This is why coaches are so often talking about asking for players to be on the roster that give you consistent effort and to try to stay as even-keeled as possible, whether things are going well or your team is performing poorly. You know there's still a standard at which you want each of your guys to perform at and consistently give you that effort.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. And so in the game for the Cavaliers, Smith is the two with LeBron at the three. Kevin Love out there with Jay Crowder. And it's Rose in at the one. Al Porzingis following the three-point attempt by Kevin Love. Here's Crowder. And sticking right with it, gets the foul with the bucket, and he'll go to the line.
Showing some initiative there.
Yeah, he takes advantage of what the defense is providing him, and that's the first bucket of the game.
Cleveland shooting their first free throw of the game right now.
And Jay Crowder, one of the bigger pieces in the trade that brought him to Cleveland, always seemed to be the odd man out with the revamped roster in Boston. But he's got some strength and length on that wing, also some toughness and depth.
Now here's Porzingis in the game against Sacramento. Very impressive. Here's Smith, drops in the breakaway layup.
JR feasting on the fast break opportunity, gets down the court, beating everyone to his position.
And that replay presented by Under Armour, showing us the fantastic steal that led to that fast break finish. Another unleash chaos moment.
And for the Cavs, getting Crowder in the deal was a big part of why they went with him. He's helped fill a couple of holes Cleveland had, and he's also on a friendly contract, so he'll be a part of this team down the road.
So it's the Cavaliers now. The Knicks making the shot. Shot clock at five. Cleveland needs to get a shot off here. Sinks the three-pointer. LeBron's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three.
James so quick there on the draw. You got to know he's ready to shoot as soon as he's going to catch that pass.
And Sessions kicks to Porzingis. Cantor with a screen on Love. Shoots off the screen. A second chance effort. Rejected by Crowder. Smith with it. He's picked up by Lee. Smith outside. And James with the basket on the assist by Smith. LeBron's got 5 points so far.
Yeah, LeBron down there amongst the trees, carving out a little space and getting the two.
Love against Sessions and stolen by Love. Here's Crowder, and Cleveland again with the bucket.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Sessions loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in.
And it's all about the release when you shoot the floater.
Rose with the ball. His scoring has been there on a regular basis. He's averaging more than 14 points a game. James outside. It's good. This time the assist from Rose. 7 points for LeBron.
Yeah, pounding it inside once again. They have taken over this game physically.
That's so nice to have the early lead. This is where you want to stick with what's working until somebody shuts you down.
Domination in the first quarter. It's been pretty lopsided. Cleveland ahead. They're up by 10. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in just a moment. Well, we know what Derrick Rose has been through, the injuries, the expectations. And we asked him how he's dealing with all of it.
I got a clear mind when I play. I can't think about the past. I can't think about if I'm going to hurt myself, if I move the wrong way. When I'm out there, I have a free mind. I have no expectations on myself. I just know that I prepare myself well. It's no pressure.
Well, and Rose says no pressure, but I have to feel like there's at least a little bit, guys, of pressure to get back to where he was.
Yeah, I mean, league MVP in 11, once considered a cornerstone for the NBA's youth movement. What we find out now after dealing with the adversity is, does he have the heart and drive?
Mm. Welcome back, everyone. A lopsided first quarter in the books already as we start the second quarter. What stands out to you from the Cavaliers in this one?
A total team effort. Each guy looking to make the extra pass.
Well, as the coach of the team, you just can't ask for anything more. Obviously, this is propelling them to their advantage in the game.
On the floor for Cleveland, getting going here in the second. They've got Dwayne Wade. Green is out there with Kyle Korver. And it's Rose. And it's Love. And at the center position, Shumpert, he's checked in for Derrick Rose. And so it's Cleveland with it. They've led by as much as 10. Green, the screen. Lock at 6. Korver kicks to Green. The dish to Wade. He gets that one. So, Brent, you averaged 21 points a game your senior year in college. What adjustments did you have to make to really score at the NBA level?
Well, I didn't have to ask for the ball much in college. But my first year in the pros, Kevin, I had to do that. I said, I'm open over here. Really, it was just a matter of being comfortable within the system. And then there's always that proving ground, Kevin, the first 6 months as a rookie or a first-year player that's getting ample time. You just want to prove that you're capable of handling your business in the league, and that all happened for me in my rookie year with the Los Angeles Clippers.
We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now. Here's Ntilikina. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Here's Baker. His three-pointer is off the mark. Cleveland leading by 8. Outside jumper. It's a pick by Love. Outside, Green. Love with the screen for Green. And another 3 for Cleveland.
And Green's become a dependable three-point threat. If you don't get a hand in his face, he can certainly knock those down.
And the Knicks decide to take their first time out here. This game coming on the heels of their win against the Kings.
And I know the defense wasn't great, but yet and still, their ability to stay composed was impressive.
Well, it led to a big scoring effort, taking advantage of every weakness. So any possession the defense wasn't aggressive on, they were on the offensive end. You know, strange to see that this Cavs team, after facing the Warriors, became one of the most elite shooting teams themselves. Their three-point shooting percentage up to about 38% last season. That was second best in the NBA. They also had the second most attempts in the league behind the Rockets.
and a new group in for the Knicks. Porzingis, he's checked in for Kyle O'Quinn. Beasley comes in for Kuzminskis. Lee's checked in for McDermott. And Tim Hardaway Jr. subbed in for Baker. And then for Cleveland, Crowder, he's checked in for Green. James comes in for Shumpert. And J.R. Smith's subbed in for Kyle Korver. Lee with the ball. He's picked up by LeBron. Here's Porzingis. And it's good. The time running down on the shot clock. Porzingis has got his first bucket of the night. And for the Cavaliers, 40% of their field goal attempts coming from long range last season. Ran a huge part of their offense.
Well, 25 made threes in a single game against the Hawks last year was an NBA record. Not Golden State. Cleveland had that record. So it's one of the many ones that they set as a prolific three-point shooting team. And interesting, because their matchups with the Golden State Warriors as being the great shooting team that they are, that the Cavs shot more last year.
That three off the mark. And so it's Cleveland, ahead by nine as the quarter comes to a close. Their shooting has been the big key. Their percentage from the field so far has been terrific. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. From one Kevin to another, you guys were dominant in that first half and you have a big lead, but do you forget about that in the second half?
Oh, yeah. We got to treat it like a 0-0 game. I know we're going to say in the locker room, we got to come out and win the third quarter. If we do that, we feel like we'll be okay. But like I said, this team is tough. We know they're capable of coming back.
Well, we'll see what happens, Kevin. Thanks. And now back to the other Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, folks. Welcome back. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. This is the halftime show on 2K Sports. Cleveland did not hesitate to set the pace. Their mission to dominate early was accomplished with a spirited 14-4 run to start. After a solid quarter of play, they held a 10-point lead. In the second quarter, they didn't play quite as well and were outscored, but still were able to head to the locker room up by a solid 9 at the half. What'd you think, Shaq, about Cleveland?
In simple truth, they just got hot. Didn't matter what the defense was doing, Ernie, they were definitely able to rise above it. Even the tough shots, did you see that one shot? I don't know how they even went down. They can carry this over to the second half. It's going to be hard to beat them, boy. Woo-wee.
And Kenny, your take on New York.
Well, they're facing a team that shot very well in the first half. Now, that being said, they probably weren't aggressive enough on the defensive end. That was the difference.
That's it for now, as the second half's just about ready to go.
The skyline of Midtown Manhattan so beautifully lit up tonight as we welcome you back to New York City. Now the second half about to start up and begin any moment. Look at LeBron James. He's really been playing well.
And I love the game plan in that first half. They really value each possession.
Efficient so far with the shots that he's taken. His contributions have been fantastic.
So it's the Knicks now. They trail by 9 points. Looking ahead, they've got the Jazz coming into town for the next game. That'll be the last of three straight at home for the team. We've got Lee, Sessions out there with Tim Hardaway Jr. And there's Porzingis, and it's Cantor in at the five down low. They're the group for Jeff Hornacek starting the second half. Brett, what about moving without the ball? Who are some of the guys that, beyond just doing it, do it with great effectiveness?
The first guy that comes to mind is J.J. Redick. Old school, in the vein of Reggie Miller running off of multiple screens with those scattered short steps to get himself on balance, square himself up, and knock shots down. J.J. Redick, Ray Allen, Kyle Korver, great players who really, in a dying art of scoring off of the screen, have tremendous fundamentals.
Rip Hamilton, too, would always run around and take advantage of those screens, and I can see him running in my mind's eye right now.
Great call, Kevin. I often read the back of Rip Hamilton's jersey because I could not catch up with the guy.
Just four to shoot. And they'll turn it over. Could not get off a shot. 24-second violation. And looking back at last season, here's a look at the three-point and two-point shot attempt averages for the Cavaliers.
And their offense centered around the three-point shot. That was the guiding principle on every trip. Their first goal was finding an open look beyond the arc, getting that extra point every chance they could.
Knicks trail by six. And Sessions kicks to lead. Cantor against Crowder. New York moving the ball around. Cantor with a screen on Crowder. Floats one up. And the layup is good. Hardaway has got 7 points.
Got to give a ton of credit to the screener there. That was a perfect pick to give his teammate the space to knock down the shot.
And one issue that has come up for the Knicks in their quest for success, Brent, is their lack of continuity.
Maybe one problem, Kevin, is that the New York Knicks organization feels just a bit too clicky between ownership and then management and the coaching staff, and that there just hasn't been the kind of connectivity that you need in order to make things grow organically. It's been very forced in New York City, and until they find that right combination, the struggles can continue.
Here's Porzingis after the made shot from Jay Crowder. Over Love. Up again. Rebound Love. The Cavaliers leading by six. James dishes to Rose. It's a pick by Love. Crowder a screen on Sessions. Rose kicks to Crowder. LeBron James on the wing. From about 19 feet. The putback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in. And the Cavaliers lead by eight.
Kevin Love refusing to give up possession of the basketball after that miss, giving it all he's got down there.
Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Here's Rose. Chalk up two there. Rose has got his first points of the night.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
And that replay brought to us by Under Armour. Another Unleash Chaos moment. One of the more exciting plays in basketball. Now Sessions. Currently averaging almost 6 points a game. There's a screen by Cantor. And Sessions kicks to Porzingis. The shot's good. Sessions making the play. 5 points in the game.
Well, Porzingis has that range, a luxury to have a guy that size who can stroke it.
And so it's the Cleveland Cavaliers bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. They've played the better game so far, but their work is far from over. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. Hello and thanks for joining us, folks. The fourth quarter of play getting started. Now here's Wade and Cleveland looking at who they've got to start the fourth quarter. They've got LeBron James. Kyle Korver is out there with Dwayne Wade. Then there's Iman Shumpert, and it's Green in at the four.
Good reach by O'Quinn getting to the shooter and reading when he was releasing it.
And nicely done, running the floor well, then attacking the rim.
The exclamation point in transition with the high percentage finish.
Now, here's Wade. There's the screen. Green, the screen. Here's Shumpert. Tips it, and Green is right there.
Oh, how about the finesse there? Nice little gentle touch on the board.
And you know, when you have that gentle touch, those tip-ins are easy to come by. Here's Ntilikina. Picked by O'Quinn. Hardaway with it. Now guarded by Shumpert. It's stolen by Iman Shumpert. Just over a minute played here in the fourth. Wade outside. Green, the screen. Passes to LeBron. Five on the clock. Over O'Quinn. Connects on the nine-footer. And now a 9-point Cavalier lead.
Guys, that's just really unstoppable. He poses a ton of matchup problems for whomever he's facing.
Beasley, the screen. final quarter of play, about a minute and a half off the clock into it. Outside Hardaway. With the floater. It's rebounded by Cleveland. Wade passes to LeBron. Green, the screen, the drive by James. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
It's just not easy to contain or control LeBron James. A nightmare when trying to stop him, especially on the drive.
Now, gentlemen. Two shots. Two shots.
He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though.
Well, still, Kevin, sitting here courtside with you in that fine suit, it gets me excited that I have another chance to watch one of the greatest players to play in the NBA. LeBron James continues to dominate.
Catching up on the changes for New York. Enes Kanter's checked in for Kyle O'Quinn. Porzingis comes in for Kuzminskis. And it's Lee in for Michael Beasley. New York calls timeout. They're behind by 10. 1:10 left in the fourth. Chance now to recognize our Jordan player of the game, Jay Crowder.
And his percentage from the field tonight seems almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting the basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
Well, he needed a game like this badly. He's been struggling for a while now, but tonight he broke out of that slump in style. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, he was able to listen in on what Jeff Hornacek said to his team. He told them not to hold back. He said, I want 100% effort out there. You can't give it, I'll get you out. No time to rest. Let's get after it. Kevin, he needs everything they've got.
And it's James missing.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
Right side, Porzingis. Sweet little floater.
And it's got to be so tough to guard Porzingis at that size, so big down there in the paint, tough to handle.
Love with the screen four-way. Love outside. And another miss by Cleveland. This one just all but in the books.
Yeah, too many points, not enough time.
Lee against Rose. Here's Ntilikina. And the miss, not the best shot selection there. And here's Rose. So we see the Cavaliers get the win here. This was a very strong showing for him, Greg. Not necessarily a runaway win, but one they'll feel very good about.
And let's face it, anytime you can go on the road and win in the fashion they did, you have to feel good about it. Really an outstanding effort all the way around.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, guys. Kevin, congrats on the win. Are you guys gaining confidence, and what are you figuring out?
Just that we need to continue continuity. We really need to pick it up on the defensive end. Offense, we can get whatever we want really at any time, but the defense is where we're going to need to get better.
That is somewhere where you have to tighten up, Kevin. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Brent Berry, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. We'll see you later.